Hello, my name is John Portfield of Eco Cars. Another great Citroen C0 all-electric car on a 61 plate, registered the 23rd of November 2011, so it's not yet 3 years old. Great spec. I think they look really nice in silver. Rear seats drop down in a 50-50 split. There's your standard 13 amp plug, which charges this car at 10 amps. And that's the connector there. I'll just show you where it plugs in. If you've seen my other videos, you're probably familiar with these cars. But this is where the 3-pin plug or the Type 2 connector will fit into the car. This will charge the car at 10 amps or 16 amps. And then the other side, as with all Citroen C0s, there is a rapid charger. This charges the car at 70 amps. From any of the most of the service stations on the motorway network in the UK now, will charge this car in about 15 to 20 minutes to 80%. So rapid charge facility on the car, rear wash wipe, high level brake light, really is in great condition. Excuse my bag. Two rear inertia seat belts with ISOFIX, two rear headrests. It smells still like a brand new car. We have side airbags as well in the two front seats, electric windows all round, and also remote central locking, two keys, the spare is a non-remote, and the remote, how great is that? Automatically folds the mirrors in when you lock and then unlock the car, opens the mirrors. Driver seat is height adjustable. There are just the driver's floor mat is here. No holes to the carpet, so it could benefit with another three mats in all the other three footwells. It's very clean, as you can see. There are no rips or tears or stains to any of the fabric. Four electric windows, driver's being a one shot downwards to isolate the other electric windows, and of course remote central locking as well. So it's really nice inside the Citroen C0. Underneath, it's basically a Mitsubishi iMiEV. Now, Mitsubishi made these under license for Citroen and also Peugeot. The Peugeot is called the Ion, Citroen's called the C0, but it's basically a Mitsubishi underneath. Foot on the brake, turn the key, turn in a hole till you hear a bing bong. Does various checks, that's it. The car is running. That's just telling me I've not got my seatbelt on and the two rear seatbelts. It's just a visual reminder, they go out, so it drives exactly as it should. We have a little day gauge here, that one guarantees the mileage, we guarantee the mileage, 10,342. Trip A, trip B, intensity lights of the dashboard, distance till next service, and at the moment there's just 9 miles range. But on a full charge, of which we've got like a fuel gauge type indicator on the other side, a full charge in this will give you around about 65 to 70 miles range. So perfect little city car. Nice radio system, single shot CD player, also Bluetooth. All the normal things you'd expect in a modern car. Aircon, got a heating system as well, of course. Also a USB port there. Quite a nice simple gearbox. Park, reverse, neutral and drive. And whatever gear you're in is indicated there. So it's in D for drive, N for neutral, reverse, and back to park. Normal handbrake. The obligatory cup holder. They really are great to drive. I love driving these cars. They really are nice. Power assisted steering. We have the normal wiper stalk this side for front and rear. And also the lights here. Also has auto lights, which is very useful. Basically the lights will switch themselves on when it gets dark. So let me just show you some of the documents. The locking wheel nut key is here. We've got the locking wheel nuts on the car. There's going down memory lane now. It's the tax disc. So it is taxed and it'll be re-taxed when it's sold, but it will be absolutely zero. And of course you don't have to display your tax discs anymore. All the manuals are here, quick reference guide, the owner's handbook, So that is present and correct. Put this away. And I'll just show you the other documentation. There is service book here, the Citroen one. It's not been stamped, but it has been checked over by Nissan. It came in as a part exchange vehicle, so they did a check on it at 10,302 miles on the 22nd of September. So everything's been checked out, the steering, the brakes, the lights, etc. And basically with an electric vehicle, with it not having any oil, engine oil, etc. That's all that it really needs. The MOT is here. It was actually MOT'd before it was due. So it's MOT'd now till September the 22nd, 2015. But its third birthday isn't till 23rd of March. So it's been MOT'd early, which is no bad thing. 23rd of November, 2011. It's classed as an electric car and taxation, so it's zero to tax. And you would be down as the third keeper. It had one former keeper, which was Citroen, and then the previous lady. So you'll be down as the third keeper. And yeah, that's all the documentation. So before I walk you around this little C0, I'll just take you for a short test drive. Right, welcome to the test drive. Now, I've rather stupidly left my bracket at back at my office. Foot on the brake, turn the key, wait for a beep beep, release the key. The car is running. I'm going to select D for drive, handbrake's off, off the brake, squeeze the throttle, and away we go. And the first thing, of course, you notice is how quiet an electric car is. And it drives like all the Ions, C0s, iMEVs we've had. Lovely and straight, no undue noises. On the dashboard, you can see you've got a red needle that just indicates whether you're in regen mode. So when I come off the throttle for this bend that's coming up, the needle goes into the blue zone, so I'm actually putting charge back in the battery. So no wasted energy. It's a different style of driving. As you anticipate corners, come off the throttle, and then of course increases your range. Drives lovely and straight, no undue noises, pulls up straight too. And the batteries are under warranty. I'm regularly asked about this, until 5 years or 60,000 miles with the C0. So you've got no worries there. There's lots of high mileage C0s driving around the UK, still driving fine. So just pull over. Pulls up lovely and straight, doesn't pull to the left or the right. The only noise you can hear is the indicator we're still on. So there you go. So that concludes the test drive, and I'll just take you now for a final walk around this little car. So welcome back from the test drive. There are no chips to the windscreen. The front tyre, 4 millimetres. The front alloy wheel's got a slight amount of grazing there, nothing serious. And the discs are fine. It's just been standing a while, so they're a little bit brown, but they will soon clean up as and when it's used. Wing mirrors are fine. Down the sides are fine. There's a tiny mark there, which we'll probably polish out. The rear tyres, again, lots of tread. 5mm alloy wheel, perfect. Locking wheel locks in place. The corners are fine. No dents at the back, no dents on the roof. Glass is all good at the rear. The other rear tyre, again, 4-5mm. Rear tyre alloy is perfect with the locking wheel nut in place. The sides are fine, no marks down the sides. Wing mirror is fine. Front near side tyre, I'd say about 3.5 to 4mm. So plenty on there. And again, slight bit of grazing on the front alloy, but I'm being super picky. Locking wheel's in place. Discs are fine. Chips, well, nothing really to speak of, to be honest. Some minor chipping on the bonnet, but I say I'm being super picky. So there we go. London congestion charge exempt. So save yourself £2,300 there. Costs about 2p a mile to run. Great fun to drive. Lots of these on the road. Lots of information about the C0, Mitsubishi i-MiEV, Peugeot Ion on the internet. You'll love this car. They really are great. So thanks for watching. Look forward to speaking to you soon. Bye-bye.